Because that's a natural weakness, isn't it? Leopard stance, you know, if it's pushing me from the front there, that's a natural weakness, isn't it? Yeah. So bear stance, the same, that's a natural weakness. Eagle stance, yeah. What about cross legs? What do you think? Do you think, What do you mean? What do you think? Sorry? Weak? Weak? No, no, if it's pushing me from the front, cross leg stance, is that weak? Will that be weak? You know, bear stance, weak. Riding horse stance, weak. Eagle stance, weak. Cross legs, will that be weak as well? Why? Of course. Yeah, you're right. It's you know, it's stronger because the leg's in the centre, whereas in bear stance, leopard or whatever, they're separated, so it's attacking the weakness. So it's in effect, it's like dragon stance, isn't it? Because the leg's in the centre, and it's the same with scissors. You know, from the front, you know, that's quite strong. Mm. You know, from the back, if you go to the back, Alistair, it's sort of, it's not too bad, but it's not as strong as the other one, is it?
Yeah.
So you just want to have a go at that, but well spotted. And well spotted. I'll have to get rid of him, he's too intelligent. Yeah. Anybody? One of the gentlemen, because you've done it before, you say. I'd prefer somebody who hasn't done it before. Put one hand on my elbow. Just like that, so you can steady it. And that hand on my wrist. And what you're going to do is bend it. You don't push with that one because you'll push me over. You're just steadying yourself with that to bend that one. That's it. Put your right foot forward and push from your back foot. That's it. So you can bend it, can't you? Mm-hmm. Do it once more. Push, that's it. Do it again. Can you feel the difference there?
Yeah.
And also, if I just do that without this hand, but I concentrate on this little finger edge, the chi flows very strongly down there, you see. Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Yep.
So, do you want to have a go at that? Okay. Yeah. But it's all about what you think. I'm just... Alistair.
Yep.
Remembered. What's your name?
Diane.
Diane. Yeah, so same thing. Just put that hand on there to steady me. And that one push in there, you see, so bend it in. So you bend it in reasonably easy. You struggle a bit, you see. And then when I do that, if you really bust the gut, you might just bend it in.
Possibly.
Starting to go in.
Yeah, yeah. Certainly,
but feel the difference in this.
The difference is incredible, yeah.
Feel the difference in that. That's amazing, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah.
And you know, when you aren't that far yet, but there's a move when you get to 62 where you do that.
Right.
And if people just go like that, you know, it's not correct. You have to do it like that. And then what you're doing is you're teaching yourself to move your chi around your body when you're doing Tai Chi.
I'm not quite sure what the difference was in what you were doing as the person.
Right. Can I stop you? I haven't made that clear, apparently. I didn't quite make that clear, so I'm going to explain again because people don't know what I'm doing. They said, yes, I knew what the other person was doing, but I didn't know what I was doing. So that I'm just being physical there, you say, trying to hold it straight while Alistair bends it. And he doesn't push with that hand, it's just this one. That hand's just to steady himself. And then when he's done that and proved that he can do it, I open the hand and I imagine, you know, I'm pushing from the edge of my hand like that and I suddenly become strong. Mm-hmm. If he really busts a gut, he will bend it a bit. But the reason I'm saying is this is, I'm going to make a point about the form, you say. If I do that and put that hand there and concentrate on both, I'm really, really strong look. And later on in the form, if you've not got there, when you do 62, you do that. And there's a tendency when you're new just to go, you know, sort of, because you're thinking about what you're doing. But when you've learnt it, you know, the Tai Chi form is all about applying your mind to what you're doing. And then when you do that, you're sending energy around different parts of your body, you see. Because when you do the Tai Chi, you're relaxed, aren't you? So, you know, I'm doing the Tai Chi and I'm doing that. But how do I know if that's working? I only know when I work with a partner and he pushes against me. Then I know that if my stances are working well. See, so if I, you know, if I'm in dragon stance and doing it like that and he's pushing me on the chest, keep pushing. You know, eventually I keep pushing. Eventually the front leg comes up like that, you see, and let me down again. That's it. And, and again. You know, and that's
significantly harder.
Significantly
yes.
Harder, you say. And it's because I'm thinking of my feet, you say. I'm letting the energy sink, but I'm not physically pushing. If you physically push, that foot becomes like a fulcrum point and you slowly get lifted. So the idea of doing the Tai Chi form is to relax all the muscles and learn to move and balance